Hi, I'm Anneke Zuiderwijk and I'm a researcher at Delft University of Technology. And in this video, we will be exploring open government data and its relationship to the open government movement. In order to function, governments need to collect and process a considerable amount of data each day. Some of this data is opened up to the public. What is this data? And what data is in the public's interest? After this video, you should be able to provide a commonly agreed definition of open government data, and you should be able to give a number of examples of this data. In order to define open government data, we first need to know what is meant with data. The DIKW model can be used for this purpose. It stands for data, information, knowledge, and wisdom. This model dates back to the 1960s and is generally accepted as one of the most well-known models in information science. Data is at the bottom of the model, and one needs to ascend from data to information, from information to knowledge, and from knowledge to wisdom. And sometimes understanding is also put in between knowledge and wisdom. Data, information, knowledge, and understanding deal with the past or with what is already known. Wisdom is at the top of the model and concerns the construction of a future vision. According to Akov, data are symbols that represent properties of objects, events, and their environments, and they are products of observation. Information can be defined as something that is extracted from data by analysis in many aspects of which computers are adept. Knowledge then applies data and information and answers how questions. Understanding is an appreciation of why questions, and finally, wisdom refers to evaluated understanding. In this video, we focus on data while we assume that open data can be used to generate information, knowledge, and understanding, and eventually wisdom. So how do we define open government data? Researchers have different opinions about this. However, they generally agree that open government data should be structured, so it should be Excel spreadsheets or comma-separated value files. Some scholars state that open data can also be in documents, videos, and audio files. The data should be machine-readable, so machines such as computers are able to interpret it, so that useful insights can be obtained. Open government data is data that governments and publicly funded research organizations actively publish on the internet. It is for public reuse, and ideally, the data can be accessed without restrictions and used without payment. This means that citizens do not need to request the data, but it is published by the initiative of the government. The data may also be collected by research organizations. Open government data is ideally accessible without restrictions. However, in practice, there may be restrictions such as licenses or unuser-friendly infrastructures to access the data. It is not about the publication of personal, sensitive, or secret data, but only about the publication of data that is applicable for opening up. The level of structure of open data is often described using the 5-star deployment scheme created by Berners-Lee. The 1-star level is the lowest, while 5 stars is seen as the ideal level. Berners-Lee states that the first level, or 1-star, is given to data that is made available on the web in whatever format under an open license such as PDF files or image scans of a table. One level up, data are made available as structured data, such as Excel tables. On the 3rd level, open data is made available in a non-proprietary open format, such as CSV. And 4 stars are assigned to datasets which use uniform resource identifiers, or URIs, to denote things. URIs make it possible for people to refer to specific datasets. And finally, on the ideal level, open data is linked to another dataset to provide context, for instance, through the Resource Description Framework, or RDF. The 5-star deployment scheme of Berners-Lee makes it possible to distinguish between different types of open data. So which real-life examples of open government data do you know? In 2006, Deckers and colleagues described examples of types of open government data. Open government data can be geographic data, such as address information, aerial photos, buildings, cadastral information, geodetic networks, geology, hydrographical data, and topographic information. It can also be legal data, which includes decisions of national, foreign, and international courts, national legislation, and treaties. The data can be meteorological data, including climate data and models and weather forecasts. It is also social data, such as statistics data about the economy, employment, health, population, and public administration. Transport data can also be open government data. For example, information on traffic congestion, work on the roads and public transport, and vehicle registration. And a sixth type of open government data mentioned by Dekkers and colleagues is business data, such as Chamber of Commerce information, official business registers, patent and trademark information, and public tender databases. In sum, different types of open government data are available. The data are often fragmented and provided at different places. For instance, this is the portal of the US government containing thousands of data sets. Eurostat provides open government data about crime statistics, social statistics, and other statistics in Europe. The OECD publishes data about how much public money governments spend on what. And JUNAR provides services to transform open government data into resources useful for citizens and customers. In this video, we discussed a commonly agreed definition of open government data, and we had a look at several examples of open government data. To conclude, we could say that open government data are structured, machine-readable, and machine-actionable data that governments and publicly funded research organizations actively publish on the internet for public reuse, and that can be accessed without restrictions and used without payment. Our overview of examples is not exhaustive, and many more examples of open government data exist. Which other examples do you know? Have a look and discuss them with your peers.